So today we continue, I mean we finish, we wrap up, نغلف, ننهي our course about data abstraction, object-oriented programming, related to some of it. And the last topic we had already started was polymorphism. We talked about polymorphism the whole week, and today we'd like to finish it with a few examples, because the past few lectures was only just introducing the topic. It was more theoretical, كلام نظري, and as one of the students asked me, we want examples with numbers. So I will make today examples with numbers. Well, examples with messages or example with numbers are the same, but maybe she feels that the examples with numbers are more real. So let's do a few examples on the three topics, on the two topics we talked about this week, function overriding and virtual functions. And I will introduce a simple modification of virtual functions, which is pure virtual functions. Pure virtual functions. ليه بس لففته كده؟ خلاص يا ابني.
ساعات مسوي دايت.
ما قلتش حاجة، أنا ما قلتش حاجة.
في ناس حياتهم يعني بس ما
لا رمضان إن شاء الله.
لا لا بعد رمضان يبقى ما فيش ابدا.
لا مو رمضان، اخذتها من جبال التخرج.
لانها نفسيه. التسويف معناه ان ما فيش فايده. بس انت لسه كويس يعني الحمد لله. يعني ربنا يبعد عنكم، ساعات الهم والغم بينزلني. يعني واحد يتحط في ساعات واحد يتحط في موقف. يعني انا نزلت مثلا الكام شهر اللي فاتوا 10 كيلو كده من غير حاجه خالص يعني. في تسجيل بس ممكن يوصل لرئيس الجامعه. يعني كان كله في اول سمستر يعني، بس الصدمه الاولى. بس ان شاء الله انتوا ترجعوا لي وزني. لا لا انتوا ما شاء الله بتفتحوا النفس. يعني بيبقى الاكل غير مفيد، يعني بتاكل الاكل وتلاقيه يعني بتتخلص منه على طول، وبرضه بينزل وزنك. يعني الموضوع مش مرتبط بالاكل بس او بالرياضه فقط. في
لما تصير
دكتور ان شاء الله اديك يعني. مش محتاج بس دكتور وخلاص، بس المهم تبقى عندك الطلبه اللي ينزلوا لك وزن. طيب بوليمورفيزم، let us summarize the rules. And the last two lectures I was talking only about simple examples. Maybe we did not understand. Type a function in a derived class. So we have, when we talked about runtime polymorphism, so today I'm talking about only runtime polymorphism. Then we talk about inheritance. We have a derived class and we have a base class. خلاص. If in the derived class you have a function with the same signature as a function in the base class, يعني ايه same signature؟ يعني same name and same parameters. Same name, same number of parameters, same type of parameters. Then this function in the derived class, in the child class, overrides the member function.
الحين نقول override ولا overrides؟
لا لا rides بالدي، بس الجملة دي غلط. A function in a derived class with the same signature as a function in the base class overrides the base member function. Sorry, I'll try to change it on Moodle also. Overrides the base member function. Mean a derived one, the child one, overrides the parent one. خلاص؟
يعني يلغي اللي في البيت.
إيه بالضبط. تمام. يلغي. يلغيها فين؟ Overrides it. لا overrides it in the derived, because in the base it is separate class, but in the derived it has the new function in the derived class and the inherited function from the base class. Both has the same name, both have same number of parameters. Which one should be used? The derived one, not the inherited one from the base.
يعني
نشوف examples على طول. يعني أنا بس يعني I try to summarize the rules so that when we see an example, then I said this is according to rule مثلا number one, we did this thing. خلاص. For rule number one is this thing. بس let's finish the rules quickly. A pointer of a base class type, we can declare pointers two classes. If we have a base class and a derived class, a parent and a child, then the pointer to the base class can point also to the derived class. Of course, in addition to the base class, pointer to base can point to base, pointer to anything can point to the same thing, but a pointer to base can, in addition, إضافة إلى ذلك, point to a derived class object. Number three, a pointer of base class type cannot invoke a derived class member function, even though it can point to derived class object, even though it can point to the children, but it cannot call the function of the children. And the opposite is true, the converse is false. A pointer to a derived class type cannot point to a base class object. Also, this is like summary of what we said last time, and let's see the examples. So if I call those rules to make it easier, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Jamil? Was that على الناس اللي جم متأخر؟ اللي عايز قهوة؟ This is an example for the first rule. We have a base class and a derived class. Both have,
of course, some data members protected. What does protected mean? Let us review all the thing about inheritance.
Can access.
Protected means can be accessed.
Access for the drive.
أيوة. Protected. And private. ممتاز ممتاز جدا. لو أنت معنا.
I am.
طيب.
It's a private domain, صح؟
Private outside the class and its children. معرفة بس في العيلة، في حدود العيلة. زي الحريم اللي في البيت. يعرفوهم مين؟ هو البيت. والآن دلوقتي الدنيا باظت. المهم. خلاص؟ يبقى protected inside the family. And private outside. Can be accessed. What do I mean? See out X. If it was not protected, if it was private, I cannot write C out X in the child. I can only write.
ممتاز. وبعدين.
عندنا
شو اثنين. بالضبط كده. هذا اللي عايز اتكلم فيه. ممتاز. We have two declaration of the show function, and since this one is publicly inherited from the base, then in theory, نظريا,
this show function should be inherited in the derived class. So we have two show functions. Which one will be used? In the base class, of course, the base one only is used because it cannot see the derived class one. But in the derived class, even though the parent is a member function is inherited, but the function with the same signature overrides the parent's member function. So this one overrides that one.
يعني تلغي اللي في
البيت. بالضبط كده. بالضبط كده. Let's see the example. مش كده؟
لا في سؤال ثاني.
طيب.
إذا كان مثلا أي class inherited class الأبو يكون يعني أول شيء يسوي اللي عند الأبو صح؟
أي
أصول يعني
بلش
من
الميرج من فوق ليه؟ إيه السبب إنه يبدأ أصلاً من فوق؟ يعني لو في declaration تقصدي ما هو ده اللي عايز أشوفه يعني how is the program running? Do we have declarations? يعني إيه situation؟ إيه المثال اللي عندنا؟
يعني مثلاً يعني إذا أنا عرفت في البيس اللي هو الـ object one تمام؟
جميل.
يكون في default constructor في الأبو والابن اثنينهم.
البيز. البيز ما فيهوش child. Base does not have children. Derived only has the base and child.
مثلاً. يعني كان في
ديفولت كونستراكتور. ما مثلا عايزين نشوف مثال عشان كده بحط امثله واضحه. يعني ليتس لوك ات ذيس وان. ممكن معلش اصلا يعني احنا بنلف وندور في حوالين السؤال مش قادر يوصل لي تخيلك ايه. اوبجكت 1 اند اوبجكت 2. اوبجكت 1 هاز الاكس والشو. Object 2 has X inherited. X inherited, protected so it can be accessed. And Y and show. Which show? Both. Should be both, but the second one overrides the first one. خلاص. So here our example. If I call object 1.show, X equals 5. Object 1.show x equals 5. Yeah. Why? Because it is the show of the parent. Object, the base. The base cannot see anything else. The base aslan has only this member. طب object 2.show.
بعد الاكس والواي
لانه
هو يقدر يسوي اكسس
override على ال اي. يبقى this show overrides the previous show. So when I call this show, it calls the derived one only and not the inherited one. خلاص. يبقى وجه المشكلة هنا فين؟ That the inherited function, the problem is that the inherited function and the function existing in the child both have the same name. If they had different names, خلاص مش مشكلة. يبقى both inherited show one and show two. But now that they have the same name and inherited, then the child one overrides the parent one, and when I call object 2.show, it only calls the this one, x and y. خلاص يبقى نسينا البيز. يبقى in the derived class since it inherits the base all those things are already here except the show is overridden by the second one.
يعني صح كلامي بس
يا حيروح على الكلاس دي
بالبداية ياخذ الممبر مال البيز بعدين اذا في عنده نفسه يشبهه يسوي عليه override.
تمام
صح.
واذا ما عندوش يشبهه
واذا ما عندوش ياخذ من البيز.
جميل. لو الاسم ده موجود في البيز بس مش موجود في الدرايف.
أيوة.
تمام
يعني
صح. صح انت كلامك كله صح.
لا دكتورة اقنعني عشان بعدين بالامتحان.
يعني اللي انت قلتيه دلوقتي صح بس
يعني هو هيبدا في المنبر
اللي في البيز. لا this is how I understand it. The whole object the whole class اللي هو البيز is inherited inside object 2. انسي بقى البيز. هو انهرت. دلوقتي when I call a function it is going to look for it here. موجودة؟ لا. موجودة في الـ من الـ ضمن الانهرتد كله جوه الكلاس.
موجودة في
الاسم. يبقى بيدور على الاسم ده جوه دي بس.
معناته نبدأ بالورد أول بالورد بعدين بالأصل.
ما فيش ترتيب معين ما أعرفش السؤال صعب يعني. يبدأ بأني ترتيب؟ هدور على الاسم بس.
هو معرف الكود ان البيس حق اوبجكت 1 والدرايف حق اوبجكت 2 فلما سوى قال لك اوبجكت 2 دوت شو فالاوبجكت 2 وين في الدرايف فراح يدفع صوب الدرايف صحيح. يعني انا اقصد ان هو يبدا بالانهرتنس اللي ماخذها الوراثه اللي هو شو مالت الوراثه هو حاطط اوبجكت 1 اي انا فاهم عليه انه راح يصير عليه اوفر رايت معناته هو بدأ باللي ورد.
بقيت
شو
هاي
أول شيء حطت
أوبجكت 1.show. أنا مش عارف ما وصل لفين. طيب ممكن ممكن نخلي السؤال بعدين. Let's take this question offline يعني after the lecture. Maybe I can understand you better. وتجيب كل الأدلة والشهود ولا. طيب.
لما
أجلس أجلس أنت
ترى
طرست جواب
شنو
so we have خلاص هنا ال object 1 object 2 بيدور جوه ال object جوه ال class derived. If it finds a function called show خلاص then it uses it whether this function is defined inside the derived or inherited. But if it is both defined and inherited, then it will use the derived one because the derived one overrides the inherited one, the base one. بس الموضوع بالشكل ده. طب how about pointers؟ يبقى rule number two, and a pointer to base can point to a derived class. This is why I declare the pointer as pointer to pointer of type base. Why? Because the pointer of type base can point to object one or object two. But if I declare pointer of type derived, it can only point to object two. It cannot point to object one. So this is rule number two and rule number four. So I declared a pointer of type base, and I make it one time it points to object one, the other time it points to object two. When I use a pointer arrow show for object one, this is clear. X equals five. But when I use pointer arrow show when pointer was pointing to object two, it also calls the base function. Why does it call the base function?
Of type base.
Because exactly. Because the pointer of type base, even though it can point to a derived class, but it cannot invoke a derived member function. But it can point, but cannot invoke. What? يبقى in that case function example number two ممتاز انتوا كويسين اهو we use انتوا عملتوه امبارح في اللاب صحيح we declare the base function as virtual we declare the base function as virtual خلاص But this is the only difference. If you look at the difference between example one and example two, is only the virtual definition. So if you define or declare your base member function as virtual, then in that case, if you access an object of type derived using the pointer, it calls the derived function. So exactly as you said, virtual. So last time you asked me to translate virtual and I found it indeed iftaradi. But it is better to understand that I searched it in English. Virtual, when you say مثلا, virtual reality, it is not reality, but it is almost reality. So virtual here is almost a function. Yeah, مش function. لا لا دي الفيرتشوال رياليتي المحاكاة يعني ميبي اي يوز misleading example يعني تقريبا function
المحاكاة
للفيرتشوال ايش لا وده اللي توصله خلاص almost a function but not a function ليه almost a function because its role هنا دورها ايه في الحياة دورها انها to be overridden بس يعني هي function علشان تتمسح بيها this function, but why do we say it is almost a function? But because you can still call this function. You have a pointer, if it points to object one, you can still call this function. But if it points to an object of type derived, then you can call the other function. خلاص؟ يبقى كده ده الكلام اللي قلناه المرة اللي فاتت. And let's see an example. I will try to put more examples in the tutorial so you better understand this thing. Oh, خلاص فهمنا الفرق ب virtual without virtual overriding. With virtual you can point to the function you need. And you must use a pointer. يعني here if I use object 1.show object 2.show it automatically calls those things. خلاص كلام واضح ما فيهوش حاجة. بس البوينتر هو the pointer allows me to do polymorphism. And with the same pointer, قدرنا نادي مرة الفانكشن دي ومرة الفانكشن دي. الفكرة في البوليمورفيزم إن those two statements are identical, but they do different things. الناس كنت استمتعوا بالبوليمورفيزم زي ما أنا مستمتع. Now we are going to define a pure virtual function. A pure virtual function is a virtual function that doesn't do anything, which only purpose is to serve, to build new classes, مش بقى override new classes, that achieve runtime polymorphism. Let's look at this example little by little and understand what it does. So here we have our first class shape. I didn't use those symbols before, but it is easy for you to understand. There is the UML diagrams, but I thought I don't have to cover them in this course. Shape. And what are the classes that inherit the shape? Rectangle. So this is how they draw it. This arrow means this is the child and this is the parent. Rectangle. Triangle. And there is a second page, because I could not fit on one page. And circle. So I have three classes that inherit classes that inherit the shape class, the base class. Follows? Let's look at the shape class. The shape class has two protected data members, the width and the height. Width and height. And it has two constructors. Those two constructors are defined inside the same class. So what do we call this? Overriding or overloading? We call this overloading. Overriding, the function with the same name must be in different classes, one in parent and one in the child. For example, if I did not have a virtual here, this function overrides that function. So overriding means function with the same name, same parameters, same signature, but defined in parent and child class. Overriding without virtual. Overloading more than one function in the same class, but with different signatures. Zero parameter, one parameter, two parameters, different type of parameters. So there is overloading between shape and shape. And if I did not have virtual, we would have overriding between area and area.
Overloading نفس
الاسم بس البارامتر. وفي الحالة دي بقوا مختلفين. What do we understand from this? I got an idea for to put in the tutorial. We understand from this that if we had خلاص نشيل virtual. نشيل virtual يعني زي example one. If we had those functions, but this function had a parameter, int, would that function override this function? هل كان حيحصل overriding? If I had those function, one in the base and one in the child, and no virtual. But this function had a parameter. This function does not have parameters. Would this function still override that function?
Yeah.
Because it is a different function. Different signature, يبقى no overriding. خلاص فهمنا؟ حطها لكم في التيوتوريال ممكن نحطها في الفاينل كمان. نحطها في الفاينل؟ أيوه نحطها في الفاينل. خلاص؟ مسحتها وقريتها.
ما كنت لعب مده؟
لا. طيب خلاص يبقى هنا قلنا ايه؟ overloading يعني different, يبقى different signature it means different functions. انما overriding you must have the same function. If they are different and they have parameters then they are different functions. المحاضرة هتنزل على المودل بس التعليقات والنكت والحاجات دي ما بتنزلش على المودل. نعمل امتحانكم في النكت في محاضرة كذا لدقيقة كذا. قال الدكتور نكتة سخيفة ولم يضحك أحد. اذكرها. معلم ما السبب؟ طيب يبقى هنا we have a default constructor that puts the values at 0, w equals 0, and h equals 0, and the parameterized constructor that takes the values x and y and stores in w and h. خلاص؟ But this is a generic shape. We call it abstract base class. It does not define any shape. خلاص؟ It only serves to store the information. This is why the area the area function, I declare it as virtual. Why do I declare it as virtual? Because I need to redefine it in the derived classes. In rectangle, it has one formula for area. The triangle, another formula for area. Circle, more a different formula for area. But general shape, a general shape does not have any formula for the area. So I define it here as a pure virtual function. A function that does not do anything. A placeholder. خلاص في مصر بنسميه طرطور. The person that does not have any role. The role is to be redefined. كومبارس. ايوه كومبارس. زي للاسف بلاش الموضوع هيتسجل والبنات هيزعلوا. يعني احيانا بعض ال مش قادر امنع نفسي بعدين اوف لاين بعد ما نوقف التسجيل.
الدكتور راح اذكرك.
خلاص ف بيور فيرتشوال فانكشن از ا فانكشن ذا بليس هولدر. يعني ايه؟ بتحجز المكان بس خلاص لغايه لما يجي السيد. خلاص زي يعني في الرتب العسكريه بيجي الجندي بس حاجز المكان لغايه لما يجي الضابط يوسع المكان ويقعد. يبقى هو كان دوره ايه؟ حجز المكان. ريزيرف سبيس. يعني we will have functions called area in the derived classes. بس بس this area doesn't do anything. Just reserve the space علشان لما نيجي نعمل inheritance تبقى موجودة. خلاص؟ So this is the function that does not do anything. We call it here pure virtual. Yeah, this one was virtual function but not pure because you can call this function and it is going to do something. ولا أي حاجة. الـ equal zero هنا you don't write functions like this. To write a function you must put braces. We don't even have braces. This means this is a pure virtual function and the whole class is an abstract class. The whole we call abstract class. Abstract class, it means it can only be used as base class. And it must have at least one pure virtual function that reserves the space. So now we have the WH, the constructors. So the purpose of this base class is to include the constructors and the data and reserve the space for this function. Now I'm going to inherit, for example, once in rectangle. When I inherit the shape in rectangle, rectangle also has width and height. So I don't need to include any more data members. So this is what we call, when I said at the beginning of this course, that object-oriented programming allows us for code reuse. Reuse the code that you have already written, especially inheritance. With inheritance, now we already have the WLH, we already have those constructors. But the constructors of the public, of the rectangle, also do the same thing. So no need to write new code. Just call the previous code. No need to have new data W and H. They are already inherited. So this is what we call code reuse. So shape serves as a base class and not just base class, abstract base class. And then how about the constructor of rectangle? The constructor of the rectangle, I define the parameterized constructor. Of course, I could have also defined a default constructor for rectangle, just for the sake of simplicity, include this default, this parameterized constructor. What does it do? It takes the A and B and passes them to the constructor of the shape, the base. So what does it do? It put the W equals X and H equals Y. How about this one, triangle? It also declares a constructor that does the same thing because the triangle also has base, we can call this, for example, the width and the height. ارتفاع للمثلث. As for the area function, it is redefined in each class. For example, for the rectangle, the area is W times H. I just return this double value. For triangle is W times H divided by 2, and then return this value. How about general shape? I don't need and I don't care. So it is just
placeholder to be able to redefine those functions. How about circle? Circle is a bit different, does not have width and height. So I need to declare, what is a dakhaldeetni arba spaces. I need to declare a new data member here, which is R, so that the area is 3.14 times R, layer pi R square. And my constructor is?
One
parameter that stores the radius, input radius in R. Does this constructor call a base constructor?
No. Because the base doesn't have one parameter.
Yes. طيب احنا كنا قلنا ايه يعني يمكن الموضوع اتنسى. It by default it automatically calls the base default constructor. يعني if you don't call a constructor, it will look for a base default constructor. But if you explicitly call a constructor بطريقة صريحة وواضحة, then it calls that constructor. خلاص؟ So it automatically calls the default shape constructor. This is why I defined the default shape constructor. If I had not defined the default shape constructor, this would be an error. Because it is going to look for default shape constructor, it will not find. No, for constructors we don't say overriding because they are not inherited aslan. But we say that the child constructor calls the parent constructor. This was the last Thursday lecture. The child constructor calls the base constructor. If you don't specify anything, it automatically calls the default constructor of the base. If you specify another constructor, not the default, then it calls that constructor. I try to include everything from the inheritance here, from this week and last week. So in that case, I finally reach my destination. This is what I wanted to do. I wanted to define a function print area that takes a reference, which we said is similar to a pointer, a reference to a base class, the shape class. Hello? See out, مثلاً, S dot area. S dot area, and it is shape, then you expect that it is going to call that virtual function, that part two, that doesn't do anything. But actually the function that is called depends on what parameter is passed to this function. Yes. One time I try the rectangle, one rectangle type, initialize with 3 and 5. And pass it to this function, then it is going to call the area defined in rectangle, which is W times H. W times H is going to print 15. Now I define a triangle and pass it to the function. So now a triangle type is passed into this pointer, then it is going to call the area member function of the triangle, not of the base. Never, it is never going to call this function. Why? Because this is pure virtual. ملهاش دور أصلا في الحياة. So this is W times H divided by 2, and this is why we get 15 divided by 2, 7.5. Next, I'm going to initialize circle using 10. What will be the values? The values will be R equals 10, W 0 and H 0 through the default constructor. But we are not using W and H, so in that case it is going to return 3.14 times 10 times 10, which is 314, because it knows that we should use the circle derived function. Yes.
Shape.
WH, we initialized W and H using the constructor. Yes, this is bad programming. I agree. I'm doing the example actually I found online included only rectangle and triangle. When I حبيت اتفلسف من عندي وضفت circle.
Of course, it is bad programming style to inherit members that are not used. خلاص. Maybe also on some compilers will get warning. Why are you inheriting those members? But I want to show you that in general we have this like base and فروع the children. You can inherit those. You can inherit and add. Maybe I could, يعني better مثلا define instead of circle cylinder has radius and height. يبقى في الحالة دي كان يعني فكرة جيدة. So we'll have the radius and the height. So I inherit the height, but I don't inherit the width. I inherit the height and the radius, and I have another function.
So
the base should have the minimum parameter data that is يعني shared by the children. خلاص. فهنا طبعا ده مش shared ابدا. This is why I put it zeros. But yeah, it is. Why is it a bad practice? Because now in every object circle you lose 8 bytes unused, the W and H. So it is better that circle, sphere, and similar shapes are grouped together in one family with one base. Triangle, rectangle, parallelogram, المضلعات, another family, separate family, so you don't waste memory space. سؤال كويس. شكرا and I was happy to have this course with you.